Dear Nigerian woman, your country needs you. You, in times past, delivered your people, saved your nation and your continent. You, the Nigerian woman, did this. First, it was in 1910 when the women of Agbaja, Kogi State, stayed away from their homes for a month in protest due to suspicions among them that some men had been secretly killing pregnant women. Their collective absence pushed village elders to take action to address their concerns. Again, in 1924, 3,000 women in Calabar took to the streets to protest a market toll imposed by the colonial authorities. In the southwest of Nigeria, female organizations such as the Lagos Markets Women Association, Nigerian Women's Party, and Abeokuta Women's Union were formidable pressure groups that talked the talk and walked the walk. Then came November of 1929, when what is now famously known as the Women's War or the Aba Women's Riots started. This protest encompassed women from six ethnic groups: Ibibio and Doni, Ogoni, Efik, Ijo and Igbo. On December 2, 1929, more than 10,000 women demonstrated at Oloko Bende against the restriction of women in government, the enumeration of men, women and livestock by the acting district officer. This event at Oloko was to spread to most parts of the eastern region within the next 4 weeks in the Ogunmwanyi or Women's War of 1929. From November to December, women from Owerri to Calabar looted factories and destroyed native court buildings and properties along with the property of members of native court. The modus operandi of the protest also involved sit-in by the women. During the events, many warring chiefs were forced to resign and 16 native courts were attacked, most of which were destroyed. It was the first major revolt by women in West Africa. In 1930, the colonial government abolished the system of warring chieftains and appointed women to the native court system. These reforms were built upon by the African women and have been seen as a prelude to the emergence of mass African nationalism. The independence we see in Africa today happened because the women of Nigeria challenged the status quo long way before the men found their voices. Dear Nigerian woman, it is 2021 and the evil in our land is far much worse than what you fought for in 1929. The burden of the colonial masters is a walk in the park compared to the burden of our current rulers. This country you nurtured is being desecrated as the blood of the innocent freely flows on our streets. Unborn children are hacked from their mothers' wombs. Kids are beheaded. Mothers are raped and slaughtered. Your men, your fathers, your husbands, your sons are dying in their thousands. They gather on social media to sing lullabies of yesteryears. Their lands have been stolen, their crops and possessions destroyed as they relocate to camps for IDPs. Your children have to pay back trillions of dollars in ill-advised loans. Dear mothers, hundreds of children are in kidnappers' dens while your men pretend they don't know. How can any leader, man or woman, freely sleep knowing children are in captivity? Only a mother's love can dare this evil. Only a mother's love can confront this monster. Only a mother's love can defy the division of tribe, tongue and religion. Your love is a universal language that men can never understand. Dear women of Nigeria, rise up in your millions and fight for us. Fight for the cowards you call father, husband, son. Fight for your daughters so they are not taken into captivity. The women of Agbaja stayed away from home to protect pregnant women. The women of Aba shut down the town to protect widows, children, their husbands and their families. You have done it before and you can do it again. Maybe as you lead, your men will come out from their hiding places. It is now the women's war. Shut your kitchens, stop the school run, shut him out of your room. Amplify your voices on social media. Protest if your priest is preaching anything other than the children in captivity. Shout down the imam who doesn't condemn this evil. Let your government know that there are women in the land. Drown out every other noise on social media with your protest. Let the world know your breast aches for your child in captivity. Let Buhari know that your 9 months of labor is a lifetime of love and care. It is your war. Fight.